And welcome to a special edition of the Inland Sports Show as we are here at the Kenny Clark Youth Football Camp, his third annual at Carter High School. Kenny Clark, one of the good guys in the Inland Empire. He has done so much to give back to the community, an NFL Man of the Year from the Green Bay Packers for his, you know, dedication to giving back. And he's very involved with Angel Tree Prison Fellowship, which we're going to get to in just a moment. But a huge turnout here at Carter High School. We're pushing 300 kids, so a lot of people in this area, they're Green Bay Packers fans, and for good reason. It's because of the impact that Kenny Clark has made. I mean, he was a high school football star. He played nearby at UCLA, and now he's one of the top young defensive linemen in the NFL. Most importantly, he never forgot about the Inland Empire. He still remembered his IE roots. He comes back, and he gives back. So here's a quick interview with Kenny Clark of the Green Bay Packers. All right, Kenny, what do you think of this turnout, man? I think it's like 300-plus kids at your alma mater here in your home stadium.
Yeah, man. It's a real good turnout, man. We out here just having fun. Like you said, it's like 300 plus kids up here. It's getting bigger every year, and it's really good. It's really good. Just thankful that all the people that's coming out that support me. I haven't seen like a lot of these guys out here in a long time. As far as like a lot of my high school friends or just people I just know around, and it's just good to just see a lot of people come out and support. And, you know, bringing kids out here and just, you know, getting the message out and just having fun, you know, just everybody getting out here, you know, being able to meet each other and learn from each other. And, you know, you never know, you know, these guys might be like, oh, I remember you from Kenny Camp. And, you know, they might find the best of friends one day. You never know. So it's pretty cool just to get these kids out here and you know, have them come out here and have fun.
Speaking of community support, having an Angel Tree Prison Fellowship out here, how special is that for you to be?
It's real special because, you know, they're dear to my heart, and they're the ones that helped me through the process of my dad being in prison. So I just feel like it's always good to get back.
Card on three.
We partner with them. In other words, we take part of responsibility for some of the financial responsibility for this, because it takes a lot of funds to put something together like this. And then not only that, when Kenny became the nominee for the Man of the Year, the Walter Payton Man of the Year, Kenny chose Angel Tree Sports as a charity that would receive the $50,000 gift. So that's how committed he is to Angel Tree. But again, you know, his father, obviously everybody knows, is incarcerated in San Luis Obispo. And, you know, that's where, ironically, that's where I did, you know, 7 years. So I'm very familiar with that prison, and I'm very familiar with what he goes through every day. And as long as I can convey that to Kenny, that, you know what, a lot of people go through it, and a lot of people come out a better man. And I know he has a strong family that circle around him. So it's good. Obviously, Kenny would love to have his dad here, you know, but I know he's here in spirit right now. And, you know, nobody could be prouder of Kenny than his dad and his mom, Nicole. He's a shining example of what a gentleman should be. And not only that, he proves it by his giving heart and what he does for the community here. And not only that, but what he does for Angel Tree, which is part of Prison Fellowship.
When we come back on the Inland Sports Show, we will catch up with Carter High School head football coach Justin Randall and hear his thoughts on the Lions' upcoming season as they prepare for their season opener against Colony. Coach Justin Randall's dad. We'll be back on the Inland Sports Show.
This is Alexander Madison. You're watching the Inland Sports Show.
Inland Sports.
We focus on the customer here. Believe it or not, that is the biggest thing for customers on an oil change. They just want the convenience of coming in, driving in, getting it done, and driving out. We just greet them, get them going, and they're done in about 10 minutes or so. We don't push any sales on them. We do the oil change, and I think that's what sets us apart, is our customer service. Vacuumed and cleaned your windshield for you as well. Everything's looking pretty good. You come come into us one time, believe me, we'll spoil you and you'll be ready to come back the next time.
Thank God, first of all. I thank the great people that I've got around me that help support me, the people that work for me. As I started, if it wasn't for the people around me, we probably wouldn't be here right now, but I've got a great staff. I've got great people that do stuff for us outside the store, and we've been very, very fortunate. Our service is impeccable, and we just keep trying to get better every year. We can do online stuff for your teams, as well as, like I said, the screen printing, the embroidery. We also have three women that do extra sewing for us, like tackle tool on uniforms, or the bling or rhinestones for different shirts for the ladies. That's why we have certain racks just for certain schools, and the fun about that is that it turns into other schools that may come in here that aren't as close, that we can do stuff for them as well. We've had very, very good customers throughout the years, and it's just been a blast.
The Seattle new NHL franchise, looks like it's inevitable that they're going to put an AHL affiliate in Palm Springs. They're going to build a brand new 10,000 seat arena in downtown.
I'm down.
Isn't that crazy?
That's cool, man.
I love that the Seattle hockey scene mirrors Patrick Leife. It's based in Seattle and now in Palm Springs.
They see how it should be.
You know, and it kind of comes back to, closer to the Inland Empire, if you consider, the Palm Springs area, the IE or not. But the Ontario Reign, that's going to be a natural rival of this new AHL affiliate.
What the name will be.
I don't know, because
we don't even know what the name of the real Seattle parent franchise will be.
We don't. Yeah, you're right. We don't know Seattle. We don't know the Palm Springs franchise. But we do know this. Agua Caliente is behind it.
Ooh.
And they're the ones, it's on their land in downtown Palm Springs. I know they have the NBA minor league team that
the
plays
Clippers,
in Ontario, the Agua Caliente Clippers.
Yeah.
So it seems naturally to put two and two together that they would move out there to Palm Springs.
Yeah.
Palm Springs could have several professional minor league teams out there in a matter of, 2 years? I think it's 2021 when they're looking at this.
Yeah, that's good.
Inland Sports. And welcome to this special edition of the Inland Sports Show as we are at Carter High School for the Kenny Clark Youth Football Camp. And join us now, the head coach of the Lions football team. And coach, when it comes to Carter High School, I don't know if it gets any bigger than Kenny Clark. And we can see by the turnout, man, this is a super popular camp.
Oh, yeah, it's always a big event. You know, Kenny's a great kid. Did a lot of great things here, wrestling, football, obviously. It's just great to see all these kids out here, from the local area, having fun with him and giving back to the community.
Yeah, I think I mentioned that on the show the other day. People forget how great a wrestler he was. I saw him down at, I think it was the Temecula Valley tournament, and he's just unbelievable. He's just a great athlete.
Oh, yeah, he's just a phenomenal athlete. I mean, I didn't get a chance to watch him in wrestling, but from the stories I've heard, he was just a monster, on the wrestling mat, on the field. I remember watching him when I came out of high school. He was just a monster. We knew he was going to be a great player.
When he was here at Carter, did you ever get a coach against him?
I did not. I think we just missed him. I think we played Carter the year after he left. But
probably a good thing.
Yeah, it probably was a good thing because he was just a physical football player. But a humble guy. People really don't know that about him. He's a guy, he'll take a picture with you any minute of the day. Great guy to talk to. He treats me like I coached him. And, I had nothing to do with him as far as his success. But he's just a great guy. Great guy.
Just the fact that, Carter High School, rolls out the welcome mat for Kenny. I mean, I think that speaks volumes that, Carter High School is just really proud of someone like Kenny who –
not only makes it big, but coach, a lot of guys, they make it big and we don't see him again. Kenny always comes back. He's always giving back. He's always doing things in the community.
Yeah, he's, you know, he's a great guy. I remember, I think the first year he did it, he was doing it at a park over here in Rialto or San Bernardino area. And I told the school, listen, he's got to have it here. Because when I was at Conley, we had Bobby Wagner come by and Omar Bolden, you know, so I said, hey, listen, and it was myself and our AD, Joe Paluba, who were like, hey, we got to get this guy here. And we roll out the red carpet, do whatever he's got to do. And this camp runs itself. I mean, he's got tons of support, tons of help, tons of coaches out here. Guys he coached him in Pop Warner High School, all out here. He's just a great, great guy to do it for.
All right, Coach Randall, let's talk about some Carter Lyon football going into this season. CBL's always tough. It's one of the toughest leagues in the Inland Empire. You got a pretty good non-league schedule as well. Talk about your schedule top to bottom, and, you know, maybe there's some wins in there.
Yeah, you know, last year was a struggle. And, you know, I told our kids we got to put the chip on our shoulder this year. I mean, being 1-9, that should piss you off a little bit.
Yeah.
But, you know, we opened up with Colony against my pops again. You know, game one at third place. We play La Quinta, who's a heck of a team out of La Quinta. I mean, Edowanda with Coach Byers over there. I mean, he's a great coach. Yeah. They got great athletes over there. San G coming off a state championship, a CIF championship. You know, they got dudes, you know. And then we play Serrano, you know, coming in, you know, and they put a good whipping on us last year. And, you know, I think it's just great, a great schedule. I think, you know, we don't want to play anyone soft. You know, we want to keep playing great competition every year, you know, to get us ready for the CBL league.
Yeah, when you look at your non-league, it's probably just equally as tough as your CBL schedule. Right. I mean, so there's really no weeks off.
Yeah, there's none. You know, like I told our kids, every day you got to bring it. Even our scrimmage, we scrimmage La Habra. You know, that's not even a week off. You know, that's a great game. And I know Frank Mazzotta for years, and my dad coached with him and all that. But, yeah, there's no weeks off. You know, like I told our kids, we got to take it one game at a time, one play at a time, one quarter, one half, you know, and we'll see where we're at the end of the game. Hopefully we got more, you know, points on our scoreboard than they do on their side of the scoreboard. But, you know, like I told our kids, you know, we got to play tough. You know, Cajon's a great school. You know, Coach Lunsford over at Rev's doing a great job. Of course, Coach Brewitt does his thing over at CV. Redlands has got a great coach. Coach McFarland does a great job over there. And then, you know, you got your Kaipa with Coach Price.
Yeah,
I mean, they're good. You know, they're a tough physical football team, you know. They're one town, one team, and they got a great mentality over there. And so that's why I tell our kids we gotta step our game up. And, you know, we're making some improvements, but we got to get better. We got to get better for sure.
When you characterize your team, would you say this is a young team, a seasoned team, a team that's strong on defense, a lot of offensive returners? Yeah. How would you kind of characterize this year's team?
I would say we're kind of young and old at the same time. We got 8 guys coming back on defense. And we got 6 guys coming back on offense. So we got some veterans, but we got some guys with, you know, some key injuries out right now. We got a couple guys with ACLs that are hopefully come back in August, and hopefully they're ready to go by, you know, game one.
Yeah.
You know, defensively, I think we're going to be okay. You know, I feel like probably my fastest team we've had, but we got to get tougher. You know, I think all across the board we got to get tougher. Last year we just took too many butt kickings, and it just didn't sit right with me, and that's not how we do business here. And like I tell our kids, you know, being, you know, 6-4, 5-5, 1-9, 2-8, 3-7, 4-6, that's not going to get it done. You know, we got to be 8 wins and above, you know, and it's going to be tough to do that this year, but hopefully we can, you know, ride it out and see what we can do.
And 2 other things before we let you go, Coach. One is, you guys are, what, Division 7, I guess, for the playoffs. So, you know, and it's not just Carter. It's a lot of schools. Half the battle is just getting into the playoffs. And then once you get into the playoffs, you know, anything can happen.
Right.
But is that kind of just the battle cry? It's just, guys, we got to find a way to get in the playoffs. And once you get in, I think you'd be, you know, super competitive in Division 7.
Yeah, I think that's our, you know, our number one goal is, obviously, like I tell our kids, our number one goal is always, you know, win the CBL, make the playoffs, and then win a CIF championship. That's just always got to be our goal. You know, nothing lower than that. If we don't do those 3 things, then we didn't have a great year. We didn't have a good year, in my opinion. But, yeah, I feel like if we could get in, you know, it's a great division. You know, it's a great division. There's great teams in there. You know, they're kind of all spread out. And there's been a lot of good football tradition in this division coming up. And, I feel, and our coaches feel, you know, if we could get in, we can get a shot maybe. You know, but it depends what type of team we want to be this year. And that's up to the kids, you know. Like I tell them all the time, it's their team.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just there. You know, I'm gonna game plan my butt off. Our coach are game plan their butt off, but it's up to you guys to what you guys want to be.
And Coach, I know it's all about this year, but if we can look ahead to the following year, just for a second, because the brand new Arrowhead Conference, which is very similar to the Raincross Conference that they have in Riverside, where there's a conference and you have three different like leagues, different tiers inside of it. I would assume you guys would be in the top, and I think it's going to be a good league for football, throwing Kaiser, Sanjee, Eisenhower. I don't know who exactly would be officially in that top league, but that's going to be a good league for football.
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, you look at it, I mean, a lot of great traditions. I mean, you look at, I think there's three CF champions in that, and I think what we're going to be in.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's why I tell our kids, that's where we want to be. You know, we want to be playing with the best. You know, we don't want to play anyone down, you know, or not good enough. You know, we want to always play the best. You know, we always want to go out there and compete with the best. If, you know, if we go 1-9 and we do that, then it is what it is, and I'll be happy about that. You know, we're 1-9, but hey, we played who we played. And yeah, I mean, looking ahead to the new league there, it's a great league. I know our AD, Joe Pluba, had a lot to do behind it. Me and him kind of brainstormed that together, kind of got some ADs on board with that, and it's going to be a great league.
Yeah.
I mean, I think all sports. I think baseball is going to be really competitive. Basketball is going to be really competitive. Girls basketball, girls softball is going to be real competitive. So I think for this whole area, it's a great thing. It's all local schools, how I think it should be. And but it's going to be great. You know, Kaiser's a great school. Sanjee's obviously, you know, won championships.
Yeah.
Ike just ran a recent one, went undefeated, lost to Kaiser. Grand Terrace, you know, they're a great school. Summit, I mean, you even look at, I think it helps out the schools that haven't had a lot of success lately, like the Coltons and the Fontanas.
Yeah.
It's going to help those guys out and get the playoffs with the Rialtos, who haven't had much success. I think they'll have success in this new conference that we're going to go to.
Yeah, and I think conferences are kind of the new trend. I think we're going to see a lot more of these, just not in the IE, but in the CIF Southern section. Coach Randall, I appreciate the time. Best of luck this season.
Appreciate it. Thank you for having me.
All right, we'll be back with more Inland Sports Show from the Kenny Clark Youth Football Camp.
How you guys doing? Coach Bass here, letting you all know that we will be opening enrollment for the 2019-2020 Booth Alternative School for Student Athletes in January. Bass is a private school here in Corona, California that emphasizes academic and athletic development for student athlete life as they prepare for high school and college. If you'd like more information regarding our private school, please feel free to reach out to us directly. You can contact us through social media on Instagram at Booth Training, on Twitter Booth_training, or you can contact us here at our gym at 951-532-4904.
This is Centennial High School football coach Matt Logan. You're watching the Inland Sports Show.
Inland Sports.
And welcome back to the Inland Sports Show at the Kenny Clark Youth Football Camp at Carter High School in Rialto. We're going to wrap things up, but first, a big shout out to our sponsors, Spoiled, quick quality oil change. I was just there on Saturday. It was fantastic. Got me in and out because I had to get on the road to go to the Riverside Smudge Spots baseball game, which we're going to talk about in just a second. Ken Sporting Goods. I wish I had my Ken Sporting Goods wet wrap kind of cool me down out here at Carter High School. And then also Boost Performance Training. If you're a local athlete, youth, high school, maybe even college, there's always something next. What's next? Who are you getting better than? You got to grind, and you can do it at Boost Performance Training. Check them out online. Visit them on social media as well, Instagram, Twitter, I would suggest. All right, the Riverside Smudge Pots, a big thanks to them. They let me come out, throw the ceremonial first pitch for their vintage 1886 baseball game against the Long Beach Oilers. It was a great time out there. They look fantastic in their uniforms. And if you haven't gone out there, I highly encourage you to. I know there's only one home game left this season, but make sure you check them out. Follow them on Twitter and Instagram. Very involved in the community as well. So if you want to see baseball from its earliest roots, the lingo, the uniforms, everything about it, it's 1886 style baseball, and it's a fun experience. So make sure you check out the Riverside Smudge Pots. I also had the honor of going to the Jamil Dada Character Excellence Youth Awards Ceremony on Friday night in Moreno Valley, put on by the Riverside County Economic Development Agency. One of the guest speakers was Daryl Thomas, former Los Angeles Dodger, won a World Series in 1981. Daryl encouraging kids to go to college, get that degree, follow your dreams like Daryl did of playing professional baseball.
If you have an opportunity to go to college, take that opportunity. Get that college degree. I didn't get a chance to go to college. I signed right out of high school. I was the number one draft choice out of high school. My dream was to play professional baseball. I wanted to get into it as soon as I could. So when the opportunity knocked, I didn't think about going to school. I just thought about playing professional baseball. My dream was to play for the Los Angeles Dodgers. I got that opportunity. The door, I knocked on the door opened. I didn't walk through, I ran through. I didn't get a chance when I signed out of high school to play for the Dodgers, but I signed with the Houston Astros, which started me on my journey. I spent 3 years in the minor leagues, played 15 years at the major league level, played for the Los Angeles Dodgers, my hometown team, born and raised in Los Angeles, got a chance to win a world championship with the Los Angeles Dodgers in 1981.
That'll do it for this Inland Sports Show. We're going up a little bit early because it is the 4th of July this week. We're going to shut it down for a couple of days so we can honor the Stars and Stripes and hang out with our family. We'll be back in studio at Teen Vision TV 16 next Tuesday as we continue our talk on high school football as we get ready for the 2019 season. For Teen Vision TV 16, Jeff Gorham, my name is Pep Fernandez. We appreciate you tuning in, and we'll see you next time on the Inland Sports Show. The Inland Sports Show is brought to you by Spoiled, quick, quality oil change. Spoil yourself and your car at Spoiled. Ken Sporting Goods, they have all of your sporting gear needs, Letterman's jackets, and team uniforms. And Boost Performance Training with Coach Ray Bass. Athletes of all levels and all sports are going to Boost Performance Training in Corona.